Hey guys, Oblivion903 here once again, and this is part 4 of my Resident Evil 2 Leon A playthrough. Now, as you saw in the last video, I made my way underneath the police station and I met up with a guy called Ben, who unfortunately got killed by the big monster that's roaming around. And I've ended up in the sewer. Now, what I'm about to do is tackle the first real boss of the game. And I've got the 4 plugs that we've been collecting as well, as you can see. For this one, I've just stocked up on all the powerful weapons I can get hold of. I've got the shotgun as well as the magnum, so they'll come in handy. I'm going to go with the magnum first, try and take out this boss as quickly as I can. Fingers crossed it all goes well. I'm currently on caution with 1 first aid spray, so hopefully I can get this guy taken care of without taking too much damage. So what I'm going to do is head into the septic room. We've been here once before, before we met up with Ada, but I've got to go back in here now, and this will trigger the boss fight. So right, so that is the thing that crawled out of Ben's chest. It's now mutating into a fully fledged BOW. It's a pretty messed up thing. It's like some sort of slug turtle looking thing with human body parts. It's really weird. And it's also coughing up little sort of leech like things. Not very nice. What I'm going to try and do is put some magnum shots straight into that. I think I've actually taken care of it. I did not actually expect it to go down that easily. Unfortunately, I've got these little things jumping on me. Oh, is it still alive? No, it's still alive. I thought it wasn't going to go down that easily. Right, now I think it's finally dead. Yeah, it's definitely dead. It's allowing me to get past now. I was definitely a bit preemptive in thinking that I was going to be able to get past it with 2 magnum shots. But, nonetheless, it was fairly straightforward. It took 7 overall, which, although I did deplete all my magnum rounds, I didn't really take any damage apart from the minute amount of damage off these leech-like creatures. I don't know what they are, some sort of parasite either way. But, managed to get rid of that guy. Didn't take too much damage, and now we're going to move on out of that section deep into the sewers. So right, looks like Ada's also made her way into the sewers.
What was that all about? Running off like that was reckless and stupid. Those zombies are everywhere. Not to mention that thing that got Ben.
I was there, Leon. I know.
Look, Ada. As an officer, it's my job to look out for you. But we're not going to get through this alive if we don't work together. Okay?
All right. We'll do this your way for now.
Right, so after that little interaction with Ada, she's finally come to the conclusion that she's going to follow me around because Leon knows best. And hopefully he's going to keep us safe. Right, he's going to head deep into the sewers now. Going to run through here. And there's a door just up here, I believe. It's where we're going to have to go next. Some blue herbs there in case we get poisoned. So no doubt that means there's going to be a lot of spiders in this area, as they're pretty much the only enemy that really poisons you. So right, we've also come to another safe room. I'm going to actually save the game here. I generally only want to save the game at the end of each part. However, I just defeated that boss, and should something go wrong, I don't really want to have to deal with it again. So, I'm just going to quickly save the game here, guys. There's one more save spot than I wanted to use, but I'm not trying to go for any sort of record or speed run or anything, as I've explained before, so it doesn't really matter too much. Right, there we go. Just save the game. Just going to place the ink ribbon back in, along with the magnum. And I'm going to guess my... I like ordering these with my handgun at the top, so it might seem a bit weird, but I prefer it being like this. So right, that should do the trick for now. I've got everything that I need as far as I'm aware. Don't forget to equip the handgun. Right, let's see what's in here. I think I actually move this out the way. I mean, is there anything in here as well? There's some handgun ammo here. I'll take that. So right, push that out the way. To reveal the door, I'm just going to go through this. It's a door to the warehouse. Right, so we're going to go down the ladder into the warehouse. Hopefully there's some sort of supplies or something here. Every little bit of ammo and first aid sprays and herbs, etc. that we can get hold of at the minute, the better, really. I've used a lot more than I intended to throughout this playthrough, a lot more than I normally would. So I've just used my lighter to turn on that lamp, and that's revealed some magnum bullets, so we'll take them. And they'll definitely come in handy. As you saw, the magnum is really effective against bosses. But right, now I need to try and find the other lamp. There must be another one. There it is there. So I'm going to use the lighter again. That's revealed some shotgun shells. They're going to come in handy as well. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like any sort of med sprays or anything, but not to worry. It'll do for now. So I'm going to go back up the ladder. I'm going to drop off the magnum bullets into the storage box as well, and I'm going to move on with the game. So right, it's going to head over to the storage box. Like I said, it's going to quickly put the magnum bullets in. And then I'm going to head down this lift. I think there's a map here as well. Not really essential to pick up. Or to sewer manager's facts. So if you want to read this, as always, pause it. And you can read the page at your will. Right, so there we go. Very exciting stuff. I've read them all before, so I generally know what they all say. And as I said before, I don't really want to make you guys who aren't really that interested spend a long time reading through them. They're there if you want to read them. If you don't, then we can move on fairly quick. But I'm going to head down this lift now. And right, there's someone else there. Right, so looks like Leon just got shot. That woman was... which isn't good. Thankfully, still alive, though. However, it is going to put Leon out of action for a little bit. So, right, here's a sewer map. Just going to take that. And now we're controlling Ada. And we're going to go after that woman. What a bitch, is all I can say. No need to shoot Leon. He's a perfectly nice guy. But, right, looks like she's heading deeper into the sewer. So I'm going to chase after her. It looks like she's gone up into this vent. So it's going to head up here. Hopefully we're going to catch up to her very soon. God, don't you just hate these loading screens. It is classic though, it's classic Resident Evil. But you probably spend more time going through these loading screens than you do actually playing the game. But I suppose that is one of the reasons why we love them. Even if it's a bit old fashioned. But this game is 17 year old or something like that. So no wonder it's like that. But anyway, going to carry on now. Right, so there we go. Looks like we've met up with that woman. Just going to leave this little cutscene now, as it's going to go on for quite a while.
You're the one who was with that cop, if I'm not mistaken. Identify yourself. Ada? Ada Wong. Ada Wong. I've heard that name before. Now I remember. One of the men from Chicago who came to assist the T-Virus research used his girlfriend's name as his password. Ada and John, I believe. How did you know? Who are you? Annette Birkin. My husband is the man responsible for the creation of the T-Virus. William Birkin. What? John's dead. He became one of those zombies. My condolences. And although I regret this, you will be joining him shortly. I won't let anyone take the G-Virus away from me. G-Virus? It's capable of creating the ultimate bioweapon. Its potential is even greater than that of the T-Virus. Then that must mean the creature in the police department is... precisely... my husband, William. And it's all Umbrella's fault. None of this would have happened if they hadn't tried to steal his research away from him.
This way.
It's sheer perfection. My precious G-Virus. No one will ever take you away from me.
There he is.
So you finally come.
Doctor, we're here to collect the G-Virus sample.
Sorry, but I won't just hand over my life's work.
You might hit the sample. That's it, all right. Okay, let's move out.
William. Oh my. Hold on, darling. I'm taking care of that bullet wound first. Stay here.
Alpha team, have you retrieved the sample yet?
Affirmative. We'll be at the rendezvous point. 1 minute.
Roger.
Are you telling me that he injected the G-Virus into his own body? The G-Virus has the ability to revitalize cellular functions.
What was that? Something's wrong. Let's check it out. Over there! Shoot! Eat this, you freak! I'm stopping it! What is this thing? Hurry! What is this thing?
So those rats were the carriers of the virus. As a result of his virus-induced transmutation, William should have lost any prior memories he had as a human by now. Even worse, every G-Virus bioweapon, including William, has the ability to implant embryos into other creatures. And create offspring. No. Too bad.
Right, so I've got to say that is probably the most important cutscene of the game. One that really does expand the story quite a lot. And it really gives you an insight into what's actually been going on in this place. And as you saw, William Birkin injected himself with the G-Virus. And that's ultimately caused him to turn into the Tyrant. It's the same guy that attacked Ben in part 3. And ultimately he's going to be the main boss of the game. Right, looks like something's just attacked Ada. Fortunately though, this is time for Leon to wake up. So hopefully we're going to go save the day very soon.
Ada?
Right, there we go. Leon's back on his feet. I'm going to head up here. Right, so this lift isn't working. So what I'm going to do is head back down here. I did forget to pick up one item. It's pretty essential for... this next part, I need to pick up the valve there that we used to open the water that had put the fire out from the helicopter in an earlier part. And we need this because the fan That's Annette and Ada climbed through. Is now spinning really fast for some unknown reason. Don't know why that is the case, but that is how it is. So we're going to need that before we can progress. Just going to pick that up quickly. And I'm going to head back down now. So right, here we go. Just sort of going to backtrack back to this area. And we're going to go ahead and gain access to the area where we need to be. Because as you remember, Ada has just been attacked and we need to go save the day. So right, here we go. I'm going to head down here. And into the sewers where Ada and Annette were. And we're not going to go the same route though, because like I said, the fan is now spinning fast, so we can't actually get there. What I'm going to do first is just quickly head up here. Because if I am right, there should be a guy here with a medal. And yeah, he's got the wolf medal. And right, we do need that to gain access to an area a little bit later on. So I might as well get that now rather than backtracking once again. Right, there's a couple of spiders here. Nothing too bad though, can easily just avoid these guys. You can kill them if you want, but not absolutely essential. So we'll just leave it at that and run past them. If we need to tackle them later, we will, but for now, we'll just save the ammo. So right, a couple more spiders here. Easy enough to run past though. So right, I'm going to place this medal into this area. There's one more, so we can't actually gain access to that area just yet. However, that's one less thing to worry about later on. That spy's getting pretty close. Managed to avoid it though. Like I said, you can kill them if you want, if you're worried about getting hit. But, wasn't too difficult. So right, going to head into this area. And this is where I need the valve. This is why we had to go back and get it. Because using this is going to lower the bridge. Which I believe up there is where Ada and Annette had their big sort of confrontation. So we do need to get up there. So right, I'm going to cross over the bridge onto the other side. And there's a couple of herbs there, some shotgun shells there. There's also a typewriter, but we're not going to use that as I'd rather... I don't know if there's any ink ribbons there, but if there is, I'd rather keep the space. There's a couple of herbs here, however, so I'm going to use these. I'm just going to make them into one. I'm not going to use it yet, though. I'm on caution. I can take a couple more hits before it becomes absolutely essential that I use it. So what I'm going to do is use the valve again to raise the platform up, and that will give me access to that area where Ada and Annette were a little bit later on. So right, I'm just going to wait for this little cutscene to play out. Right, there we go. So right, now we're trapped on this side, however, that is where we actually want to be. So I'm just going to go through this door now and move on to the next section. Right, so now we're in some sort of tunnel. So right, I'm just going to keep on running through here. Right, it's quite a long tunnel. Right, there's Ada. She's shooting at the water, presumably at the thing that was attacking her. Oh! Shit, that was close. Right, being attacked by a giant crocodile. Things just keep getting stranger and stranger in this game. Right, just gonna head down here. There is a little secret to this, which basically makes it a lot easier. You can't actually kill it. Right, so there we go. That cylinder has been dropped on the floor. You can see it there. What I'm going to do is wait for the crocodile to pick it up. And there we go. Now, if we shoot the cylinder, it's blown up the crocodile's head. And has destroyed it. Very straightforward to do. There's no other way to kill the boss as far as I'm aware. And obviously, one handgun bullet just destroyed that absolutely giant creature. Right, that door's now locked. So we're going to release the lock, and then now we can get into this part where Ada was. Thankfully she's safe. So right, now let's go meet back up.
Leon.
Right, looks like Leon is really succumbing to his wounds. He's going to need some help. We're going to need to bandage that up as soon as possible. Oh, thankfully Ada had some bandages. What would you know? So that's made Leon better. Now he can sort of act normal again.
John's dead.
What?
Never mind. Let's just get out of here. The sooner the better.
Right, so now we're heading up this ladder. Gonna move on now. I think Ada's gonna follow us. So right, now we're back where Ada and Annette were. And what I'm going to do is just head up here quickly. Right. There's a medallion on the floor. As you remember, I used one earlier, the silver one. This is the other one, this is the Eagle Medal. Gonna need that to get access to that area. And there's another diary here. As always, gonna flick through this. You can pause it if you want. Right, so there we go. And there's something else here as well. Can I pick that up? Doesn't look like it. So, right. Actually, before I do, I'm just going to double check there's nothing in here. You never know. No, there's nothing. So, right. Going to head down here. And what I'm going to do is use the valve once more to give me access to the vent. It's going to allow me to get back into the main part of the sewer. And go ahead and use the Eagle Medal to get into that area that was blocked. So right, there we go. We've still got the valve. I don't know whether we need it again or whether it's just giving us it in case we decide to use it if we want to go a different route, etc. Obviously, we can go back and get items that we may have missed. So whether we need it again, I honestly can't remember. However, I'm going to run through here quickly. Just avoid these little insects if they're still in there. I'm just going to climb down this ladder and I'm going to head towards where the water was flowing, blocking the door. Put the medal into the slot and then I'm going to head into that area. So right, there should be some spiders here unless they've disappeared. No, looks like we've got to deal with zombies instead. But I'm not going to bother with that. I'm just going to run on and move on. I'm going to save the ammo. There's no point dealing with them. We're going to be out of this sewer very, very soon with no need to ever return. Right, the spiders are still here. Just going to run past these. Right, just going to quickly pop this medal into here. I'm not even in the right position to do so. Right, so there we go. That is the second medal in. That's clearing up the water. There's something from the floor now giving us access to that area. In that we'd have a spider just sit and wait for us to do that. They don't actually bother to attack us while that's happening. But never mind, it's getting pretty close though, so we're going to go through our door. God, I really hate those spiders. As easy as they are, I just really hate them. They're just really creepy. So right, you can hear some bashing. Definitely not alone in this area. And that means a boss fight is coming up very, very soon. Right, is there anything here to pick up? Doesn't look like it. So I'm going to head down here. Right, there's a tram. But I think there was a switch around here. I think I need to press. Right, I'm going to turn the power on. And right, now we're going to head into the tram. What I noticed as well is Aid is giving us full health again. I was on caution, so good job I didn't actually use that herb. I've got it for another day now. Which I imagine with the upcoming boss fight, I'll probably need it. So right, now we're going to head on. It's going to move up here into the next section. I don't think the boss fight is quite yet. Oh, shit, I might be wrong. Right. That thing is here. It's absolutely destroying our tram. So we need to avoid out of the way that it's coming through. Right, has it gone for now? Not totally sure. Yeah, I think it's for some reason just disappeared. Very odd. You'd think it'd keep attacking. But never mind. Doesn't look like that's the case. So, right, going to head out of the tram now into the next area. As you can see, William Birkin is on our tail. Which is going to mean that we're going to have to start fighting him very soon. Right, I think we can use the lighter here. And that would make sense. So right, that's lit up that area. No idea what it was actually indicating. Apart from the fact it's just showing us an item is on the floor by our side. Right, it's the W box key. So we now need to go find the W box. Whatever that is. And use it. So we're going to head through this door here. Oh, there's a couple of zombies here. Right, let's take care of these guys. Oh, shit, he's got my leg. What a sneaky son of a bitch. Right, there's another one here coming up behind us. Going to quickly take this guy. Hopefully he doesn't have a leap of faith as well. Right, it's just for one zombie. Right, yeah, that's all good. There might be more, I'm not totally sure. Right, there's a door there. So what I'm going to do is head up here. Oh, there's more zombies here as well. But I want to head up here just in case there's something I'm going to miss. Right, it looks like Ada's helping as well. Like, one of the zombies is still alive. Right, just going to wait for him to get back up. There we go, I've taken him down. That's them both taken care of. Just going to reload my gun quickly. Right, so there's a zombie here. Right, what's that? Right, I think that's an attachment for my shotgun. Right, that could really come in handy. Hopefully I can go back for it. I ideally don't want to have to use like a herb just to get rid of it. I'd rather keep it. So I'm going to go through here. Hopefully there's some sort of storage box before I have to move on from this area. Because once I move on from this area, I can't come back. And then that really is going to come in handy. Right, there's more zombies here. Right, I'm going to quickly run on by. Right, that's that one taken care of. Right, there's even more of them. Right, it's going to reload my gun. Just going to keep on top of things. Right, there he is. He's back again. Is that him taken care of? Good now. Yeah, it is. So I'm actually going to head down here. I think it's a dead end, but it's worth checking out. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, shit. There's a zombie there. Right, there's more herbs there. So I suppose if there isn't a save point, I can always use my herb. Get the shotgun part, and then I can make more herbs, I suppose. But I'm going to go up here first and just see whether there is anything. Because ideally, I'd like to keep my herbs if possible. Right, yeah, it looks like there's a safe room here. Which I will be saving the game at before moving on. Because like I said, once I leave this area, I can't come back. Right, some magnum bullets there as well. So right, I'm just going to drop everything off that I don't need. I don't think I need the W box key yet. I think it's when I leave this area and move on that I will need it. So I'm just going to leave all that behind. Now I'm going to head back down. I'm going to quickly get those shotgun parts and those herbs. And then I'm going to come back up and get everything else in this room. And then I'm going to save up and then I'm going to move on to part 5. But that doesn't mean you need to go though, guys. No, you can still watch. Obviously, you want to see what this Adam for the gun is about. So, yeah, don't leave yet if you were thinking of doing so. So, I'm just going to head for this door. I'm going to head back to where that gun add-on was. And then, I'm going to go back and get the herbs. So, right. If memory serves me right, it should just be up here. Right. So, what is it? It's a shotgun part. Yeah. Thought that's what it was. So, right. So, I'm going to combine these two together. It's allowing me to carry more ammo. And it's called a C shotgun now. So it's a full size semi-automatic shotgun. A longer barrel results in more concentrated blasts, so it's a more powerful shotgun than the one that it previously had. Definitely going to come in handy in these final stages of the game. Because after this part, basically, if you don't know already, what we're going to do, we're going to head down into the underground lab where Ada is heading to try and find John. And basically, this game is going to come to a head there. There's going to be lots of action. Lots of killing, lots of blood, lots of gore, lots of everything. And yeah, it's going to be absolutely fantastic. And I've got to say, it really is one of my favourite games. Definitely in my top 5. And I really can't wait to get further into this and finish it once again. I finish it so many times and it really doesn't get boring for me. Absolutely love the Resident Evil series. And you'll definitely be seeing a lot more of it on my channel. Obviously after this, we've got the second scenario with Claire. And find out what happened when the truck exploded at the start of the game. As you remember, she was trapped on the other side and from what we were. So we're going to see what Claire's up to. And then we're going to do the game in vice versa. So Claire's going to be tackling this side and Leon's going to be tackling the other side. So yeah, a lot of stuff is going to happen just in this game alone. And I'm also going to be playing all the other Resident Evils. Because like I said, it's an absolutely fantastic series. One of my favourites of all time, if not my favourite. But right, it's picking up all this ammo here. And I will be saving as well. I was going to see if... I think I've got to use that W box key when I leave this room. So what I'm going to do is just pick up these ink ribbons and quickly save the game. So I'm going to conclude this video here, guys. So thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you check out part 5 where I'll be tackling William Birkin for the first time properly and heading on into the underground lab, which is the final section of the game. However, it is quite a long part, so no doubt it will be split up into more than just the next part. It'll probably be a part 6, possibly a part 7, who knows? You'll have to watch and find out. So until next time, guys, bye for now.